SMILE gave me the opportunity to broaden my horizons on things I would have never thought I would have liked to do.
Without SMILE, I wouldn't be able to make connections to find my way to college.
SMILE is a after-school academic enrichment program for minority and educationally disadvantaged students. And it is a club-based activity in schools, and there's usually 20 students per club and two teachers who run the club. And they do hands-on science and math activities. I first saw it in some of the most rural districts in Oregon, where it was mostly Native American or mostly Hispanic, and kids piled in at the end of the day before the teacher could even say, "Wait, I have to go to the bathroom." They were excited and they wanted to learn new things. And what I realized was they have no idea, outside of the SMILE program, what careers are really available to kids who are interested in science and technology. The SMILE program just opened up their eyes to all of these opportunities, and I realized that there are so few programs that cause that kind of motivation and excitement.
In SMILE, you really do want to be the smartest person in the room. You don't have to hold back what you know. You want to go and share your information and hear what other people know as well.
We like the model that we've started in Rhode Island, and we have selected universities that in other states that could serve as what we call hubs, like URI is a hub for the SMILE program. And then within a 50-mile radius to find school districts that are in need of outreach programs that the SMILE program would complement. And I think that the idea of university-SMILE program collaboration is very important.
SMILE is all about giving you experience with hands-on activities. So you really get to see different aspects of science.
I know the high school students absolutely love doing biotechnology, and we will give them all the equipment that people who work in the field would be using. Through Amgen, we are able to use their materials. They look like the world-class investigators of crime scenes or just innovators in biotechnology. Another activity that kids love to do in the middle school is when they build wind turbines. Because in this case, the wind turbine is not just a model, but it actually works, and they have to produce electricity. And they love the challenge of seeing who can design the best blade design numbers and who gets the highest electricity production. And they are not only competitive, but they love the whole concept of working in teams of kids from schools all over Rhode Island, seeing that SMART comes in a lot of different sizes and gender and color. So that everything to do with the middle school and building and transportation excites children. In the elementary program, there are any number of activities that I can think of, one of which is they do water testing, and they're using real equipment and taking temperature, pH, levels of nitrogen, and they've never handled equipment like this in their own classrooms, and they feel like wonderful scientists. And that's exactly the feeling that we want to give them, that science has these wonderful pieces of equipment or tools that in some cases look like toys, but really are the motivators to stay involved in SMILE and stay involved in STEM.
I started SMILE when I was in eighth grade, and I continued on all the way through middle school and through high school and now into college.
I'm originally from the Dominican Republic, and as a student from there, I had the initiative, but when I came here, I didn't know how to apply, what I wanted to do, really, how I would get into the system of science. But SMILE was a pathway that brought me to school.
We've had 21 years of success at SMILE. We've put over 2,000 children through the program. Over 650 have graduated from high school and gone on to college. and we feel it's time to spread the concept of SMILE to other states. The United States is suffering from fewer and fewer people going into STEM areas. The Department of Education from the United States listed it as only 14% of undergraduates major in STEM. In SMILE College students at URI, we have 73% majoring in STEM. SMILE does belong in every school in every state. It would look a little different because the numbers would be huge, but on the other hand, the effect would be huge.